Well, I think our first reactions is this. This is the first judgment, long judgment, dealing with the serious issues of the interface between international law and the constitutions of Kenya. And I am happy that the judge, at least he has upheld the fact that the constitutions of Kenya is superior to the Rome Statute, so in as far as the Kenyan law is concerned. Of course, the significance of that when we go to that other second petition, sir, would become apparent. But of course, the disappointment is that the fact that having upheld the supremacy of the Kenyan constitutions over the Rome Statute, in the judgment, there is nothing to indicate that that supremacy has played a part in much of the decisions that the judge has ended up making. But again, the good beauty with the Kenyan constitutions is that that will go to the Court of Appeal and ultimately to the Supreme Court if we do not get it reversed before the Court of Appeal. And of course, the good thing about the judgment is that the judgment, by ignoring a number of obvious issues, it becomes a kind of judgment that we say is every lawyer's dream of a good judgment to appeal, a judgment that is very weak on the key issues. And therefore, for us, as far as we are concerned, and we thank the court for giving an order of stay, as far as we are concerned, ICC gets nothing immediately from this judgment. But even more importantly, is that from one of our strategy, is that the strategy where the High Court would give an order that does not allow the petitioner has long been factored in our game plan. And therefore, we start the long procedure in which, as far as the long contest with ICC is concerned, we are comfortable. We had anticipated everything and all our actions, at least bears the positions that I expect for the next 1 year. I don't expect Mr. Baraza to go anywhere. So we are okay. The game is on.